Lately, we've seen a growing frustration from the part of Turkish officials in terms of the rhetoric. Akar talked about Greece and Cypriot offensive acts. Çelik said Greece is provocative. Where do you attribute this escalation?
I think we're seeing a deepening of the dynamic that's been playing out in the Eastern Mediterranean over the last couple of years. Turkey has felt increasingly encircled by hostile powers, by an alliance of hostile powers, and yet it has consistently responded with provocative moves intended to break out of this isolation, which have, not surprisingly, only reinforced fears amongst Turkey's neighbors and reinforced the kind of cooperation that leaves Turkey feeling encircled. Mm-hmm. Right now, you see Turkey's efforts at rapprochement with Egypt not having gone as well as Ankara hoped. You see what looks to be a new crisis brewing with Israel over the arrest of an Israeli couple on trumped-up spy charges. At the same time, of course, the Greek-French defense deal, growing U.S.-Greek cooperation. Again, I think this has just enhanced the dynamic that led Ankara to take the steps that in turn led to the very things that you're seeing today.
For the first time, Erdogan talked publicly on the possibility of losing the election. Is this a sign of realization that he's isolated internally and externally?
It's very difficult to know what's going to happen in the upcoming Turkish election. We're at a very unique point where some observers are very confident that the election is going to be fair, that given Erdogan's poll numbers, he's going to lose decisively, and that's going to be the end of Erdogan. You have other observers who are equally confident that despite these dynamics, Erdogan is committed to holding on to power in an authoritarian way, using all means necessary, and that he will ultimately succeed in doing this. There is a long tradition of free and fair elections in Turkey. The country has had coups, but when it's had elections, they've been fair and the results have been respected.
And what about the F-16 upgrade? Is Turkey in a position to negotiate alternate sources for military equipment?
The U.S.-Turkish relationship has been changing, as I think we've discussed on here in the past, slowly but consistently. And you've seen a move from, the U.S. government's concern really being how to avoid losing Turkey to a greater sense that the United States has to take tougher measures to stand up to Turkey. What happens with Turkey's request for new F-16 purchases and F-16 upgrades is really going to be a test of how far this shift in U.S. policy has gone. And again, there are people who are watching this very closely who think at the end of the day, the fears over losing Turkey, the fears over Turkey turning to Russia are going to be great enough mm-hmm. that the U.S. government will approve these sales. And you hear other people predicting that the frustration with Turkey is so strong, the sense that the United States has to stand up to Turkey finally is so strong that without some kind of compromise on the S-400 Russian missiles, this F-16 sale will never happen.